गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम दीप्ति स्मिता प्रियदर्शनी फ्रॉम सेंचुरियन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, भुवनेश्वर, उड़ीसा. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय टॉपिक, दैट इज हैंड ज्योमेट्री बायोमेट्रिक्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज बायोमेट्रिक? बायोमेट्रिक इज ए ग्रीक वर्ड. बायो मीन्स लाइफ, मेट्रॉन मीन्स टू मेजर. बेसिकली बायोमेट्रिक इज ए फीचर विच इज यूज फॉर द वेरिफिकेशन पर्पज as well as security purpose on the basis of physiological and behavioral characteristics of a person. Nowadays, biometric is a trending method used in forensic science for verification and identification. Biometric are of two types. One is physical biometrics and another is behavioral biometrics. Hand geometry biometric comes under physical biometric. Hand geometry was introduced by David Sidlowski in 1985. In this system, the measurement of the palm is recorded and measurement is done by measuring the width and length of finger and thickness of the palm area. Next slide. Hand geometry system. Next slide, sir. The device which is shown in figure is called hand geometry system. In this system, there are two steps. One is enrollment and another is verification. Enrollment. Next slide, sir. Enrollment. In this step, a person only has to place his palm on the device surface, then the scanner scan the measurements of the hand, and then scanning is stored in the database. Some systems have pegs and some systems do not have pegs. Pegs help user to place the hand in a proper position and also help the device for better measuring, but sometimes it creates problems. It can deform the appearance of hand so that measurement are not so precise. Then next, verification. This step is simply called sampling. In this step, the measurements is captured by a scanner and recorded in the database. Scanner usually use CCD camera. In this step, the following steps are also used to verify the measurements of a person's hand, that is image acquisition, image processing, hand feature extraction, matching and result. Then image acquisition. Next slide, sir. In the image acquisition step, the user only has to place his hand on the device. The image of the hand is captured using only ordinary digital camera. This system scanners usually CCD camera to capture the image of the hand. Then image processing. The next, it is related to the preparation of an image for later analysis and use. Some images need to be reduced noise, such as lightning effect, background and image should be removed and need to be amplified, enhanced and filtered. Binarize the image is important. It means convert the grayscale image into black and white photo, because as shown in the figure, the black and white photo of a palm is looking very prominent than other images, so that measurements can be done very properly. Then hand feature extraction. Sir, next slide. There are several features those should be extracted from the hand. The features are length of all the five fingers, width of all five fingers, perimeter and area of all the five fingers, circle radius of both lower and upper of all the five fingers, and largest inscribed circle radius. What is this largest inscribed circle radius? This is a technique which is used to measure the gap between the fingers of a person. When a person places his hand on a paper, then the gap between two fingers form as a shape of triangle. When we join the tip of both both the fingers, then we get a proper triangle. Then bisect the sides of a triangle where the three bisectors meet inside the triangle, that is the midpoint. Take that midpoint as the center of a circle and make a circle inside the triangle. Then we get a diameter of the circle. The length of the diameter is equal to the distance between the fingers. By this method, features are extracted. Then matching. In this step, only comparison is done. The user's generated features templates are compared to the templates stored in the database. Then result. After matching, we get the result whether the extracted features are of a genuine user or a fraud user. When the matching attempts exceed the predefined thresholds, then the attempt is considered as an imposter access, otherwise attempt is client access. Next lesson. Then comes to advantages and disadvantages. Advantages. This is simple, inexpensive, and data is easy to collect, and computations are also very easy and storage efficient. And disadvantages. It is large in size and only can be used for verification, not for identification. And also many hands are same in shape and size, and systems may get confused in between genuine user and fraud user. Then comes to applications. At most of the crime scene, palm prints are found. By using hand geometry system, the suspect can be verified, and also it can be used in case of mass disaster, used in to verify whether palm print belongs to a human or an animal, and used to find out the sex and age of a person. Thank you very much.